Hey guys, Darth Clark here, back with part 6 of our Fallout 4 playthrough. So, it feels like it has been 90 years since we have played this game, and to be fair, it's been maybe 2 or 3 days, maybe longer. It's been a long time, so a little shaky on what happened. I do remember that my last episode was called Nick Valentine, and I think that was one of the things we did was Nick Valentine's mission, which was, you know, going to save him from being locked up. Anyway, I'm pretty sure that was one of the things we did. But I remember that was one of the things we did, and now one of our missions is to go talk to, Nick Valentine. Is one of the things we need to talk to, because we're going to talk to him about Sean's disappearance. And then we have a variety of other missions as well to look at. But yeah, so we made good progress. But yeah, it feels like it's been forever since we actually, you know, did anything on Fallout. So, pretty happy to be back on and doing it again. So, the question is, what do we want to do today? Let's see. It's also weird because it's been a while since I played Fallout. No, I've been playing Fallout a lot recently. And then, I've been kind of wanted to take a break, so I did. And it's just funny. I wanted to take a break and I did, so I'm a little rusty. Okay, so I have the first one of those, I have the two ammo, I have one gun, I have one armor, I've started health, rifleman, of course I have the water one and that one. Okay. Alright. Anyway, and gun-wise, what am I looking at here? So we, of course, have me sniper, have my shock baton, of course my go-to, righteous at 30. Over 1,000 rounds of my pistol, my double barrel, my bubble barrel, pistol, that one, and then we have Rainer's rifle, very good one. Not too many bullets at the moment. Okay, cool. Okay, so the question is, what to head to first? I'm just trying to refresh. So let's see. We could do that one. We could also do. We could do this one. Going into that one first might not be a terrible idea. Let's see. It's hard to say, man. All right, maybe we could also start with just exploring and clearing some places. That wouldn't be a terrible option. Let's see. We could discover the combat zone. And what do I look like again? Oh yeah, I'm mostly Brotherhood with a little bit of serial killer mixed over the top of it. Okay. Like I said, it's hard to remember what's happening. okay. Let's go ahead and go explore the combat zone, shall we? Music is going in right now. Yeah, it feels cool. It feels good to be back on Fallout. It's been a little bit. I've been playing different PC games and mostly just taking a break, just a few days off from my personal Fallout stuff. Not anything on camera, but for my personal Fallout stuff, I've been taking a break, and then just the way it worked out, we've been off Fallout for a few days as well. So, you know, so between those two, it's been a while since I've been on, but happy to be back. Okay, so let's see, the combat zone is right over there. So, all right, come on, puppy. I know, it's way too far range for that. Well, it wasn't pretty, but, you know, to be fair, I'm kind of rusty. Oh, that was a great shot. You should be proud. Here, how about you hold that? Well, it wasn't my prettiest engagement, but, you know, like I said, in my defense, it's been a while. I'm pretty rusty, to be honest. All right, let's see if we can... How much health are we down? About 40. Okay. Well, then go ahead and take a health... a blood pack. It's not a bad waste or anything. Let's see. Ammo... All right. Na 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 ba na na. Take all of those. All right. Let's see. He had some ammo. Otherwise, nothing good. All right. So the other one was over here, or you know, across on the other side. Ah, there we go. Oh, the frames, though. There you are. Okay. Otherwise, nothing too juicy. Nothing it too juicy. Perfect. Combat zone. We can go ahead and poke inside, see the sights, see what there is to see. Who knows, maybe there'll be something great inside. Ooh, like shotgun shells and money. Can't open that, and I don't have the terminal abilities for that to open it, otherwise. We'll take it, it's worth cloth, it's not like a bad waste or anything. Let's see. I doth wonder if I should switch tactics here. Alright, let's go ahead and give this a save, because yeah, I do know what's ahead of us, and it's not like super hard or anything, but you know, you never know. Crazier things have happened. You might accidentally get yourself killed because you're stupid. I took a switchblade. Didn't actually mean to. God. We'll loot the bodies after they're all dead. How about that? A lot of them have melee weapons. Coming for that booty. I'm coming for the that booty. I'm coming for you, bro. I'm gonna beat you to death with my little electric stick. Come here. That's for you. Sometimes a good melee weapon's all you really need.
We don't want any trouble. Not anymore, at least.
Alright, yeah, just...
I'm too pretty to go out like
this. Alright, y'all just shut up for a minute. I have looting to do. They're all done dying, if that's what you're asking. They're all done being dead. But I ain't done looting, lols.
So you wanna talk this out like civilized folk?
No. You are now able to build potted plants at settlement workshops. Nice. I would love to just bash up your theater some more. I'm not done looting. You just take a deep breath, bro. Money, because it doesn't weigh anything. It's easy, like the easiest form of cloth there is, man.
We were
Dog tags are only good for steel, and steel's easy to come by. Puppy, could you not? Thank you.
You finished tearing the place up now?
Nope, shut up. It's a lot of noodle cups. Ooh. That'll have screws.
You all done killing each other?
Yeah, I'll take one ceramic bowl, but we're not gonna get too crazy over it. Food items. Do you have a thing about being in my way? He's like, yes, actually. Now that you bring it up.
So you wanna talk this out like civilized folk?
No, I don't. Shut up.
Gonna bash up my theater some more.
I'm gonna continue bashing up your theater. Also, zombie slayers online.
Hey! You all done killing each other?
I'm still ignoring you. Take those.
So you wanna talk this out like civilized folk?
Nope. He has a little bit of ammo, nothing crazy on him though. Ah, there we go, here's another area. Let's see. Ooh. First aid. You know what's in first aid? They're like, healing items? Like, exactly. Knuckles, machete, combat knife, pipe wrench, board. Didn't I also pick up like like a switchblade? I did. Don't need that because my shock baton, unfortunately, is really good. Now there's something. Unfortunately, it's just not like it's not quote unquote the coolest weapon, and so like it's not doesn't feel as fun to use just because it's not as cool looking, like as other guns maybe. So. It's kind of a maybe a shallow, stupid reason to not like a weapon, but, you know, here we are. I'm still ignoring you, by the way. Alright. Still ignoring you. Ah, there's another.
Why don't you come over here? Show us you don't mean no harm.
I might have accidentally picked up another gun I didn't need, by the way. BTW, I don't need you.
We were rooting for you the whole time.
Yeah, I'm sure you were. I'll take that. I'll take your that. I'll take those. All right, nothing else too good over there. Nuka cherry, ammo box, air horns.
Got it.
Ammo. Little bottle cap. And don't worry, Mr. Dude, I'm almost done looting. Keep your hair on. Okay.
You finished tearing the place up now?
Almost. He doesn't have anything good. Alright, let's search the last body. Okay. There we go. Alright, so switch to this.
We were rooting for you.
Is it over? Well, that could have gone worse.
Yeah, you could all be dead.
I don't know. Seemed quite the performance from where I was standing.
Are you fucking high or something? Why am I asking? Of course you are.
Was still winning the fight, wasn't I?
You strung out and... Of course, I suppose you ain't gotta worry about that now.
Oops,
seems
sorry.
This one just put us out of business. I'm not sure if I should kiss you or have my little bird here feed you your own entrails.
I told you to quit calling me that.
I saved your lives. Should be grateful.
Grateful? For killing our meal ticket. Excuse me if I don't rush to embrace our savior. They weren't the friendliest bunch, but keeping those idiots entertained at least kept the lights on.
To hell with them. More'll come. Just need a quick breather and I'll be ready to go.
Oh, breather. What? So you can slam more of that junk into your arm now. Now, you know what? I think this was a blessing in disguise. You caught the end of that bout. What'd you think of Kate's work?
Can I be honest? I didn't see any of it.
Not sure. I didn't catch the whole thing.
Yeah, I guess you were pretty busy cleaning
house.
Yeah,
I was killing all those people.
Impressive work. Makes me think you're good enough to do me a favor. So here's my predicament. I suddenly got no audience.
No audience means I got no caps coming in. And if you ain't bringing in caps, little bird, you ain't an asset. You're a liability to me and to yourself. So, here's what I'm thinking. What say I let you take over her contract? She goes with you, watches your back. Look, you'd be doing me a favor while I try and get the place back in order. What do you say?
Me and her.
She looks like such a crackhead.
Why would you want her to go with me?
Yeah, Tommy. Just why the hell are you trying to get rid of me?
Look, truth is, all that junk, it's been making me careless. And I don't want to be the one doing color commentary when you finally hit the floor. All right? So just do me this favor. Both of you. Please.
I'd like to know what Kate thinks.
Don't I get a say in all this?
That's why I asked.
Contract works. Besides, you really want to stay here? No audience, no caps, no one to talk to, but yours truly.
Jesus. Point taken.
Atta girl. So, she's on board. Now what about you?
Sure. I could use someone watching my back.
Good. It's settled then. And here, take this. It's the purse from the last fight. Exterminator's fee.
Now just wait a second. What exactly are you gonna do without me here?
You don't need to worry about me. I'll get this place set up right. Maybe find a less blood-soaked clientele. Now get the hell out of here. You ain't welcome anymore, little bird.
You're a real son of a bitch. You know that, Tommy?
You don't have to tell me.
I guess just confront me then when you want to head out.
You know what? I say we take her.
Kate.
We'll see how it works.
You ready to head out?
Ready.
About time I got out of this place. Let's go. Don't look at me that way, you dirty little mole rat.
Chill, lady. He's my puppy. Catch you later, pup. All right, Kate, you ready?
Hey.
I'm trying to...
Oh, sure. Make me carry more of your junk.
As it should be. All right, she only has that. My curiosity was if I could give her, let's see here. Let's grab you this. I'm gonna take this. Let's give you... Alright, hang on. I'm gonna see if I can give her a full set of armor. So she has a leather right leg. Okay. So right leg, left leg. So we have both of the legs. Raider left and right arm. Ooh, let's grab Raider leathers for sure. Alright, so now she has the... two leather legs and road leather, and then Raider leathers. I need leather arms of literally any kind. If I can't get those, then I'll give her Raider, but... Oh, there's someone I missed. Anyway, there we go. Right arm. I need left arm now. Ooh, let's give her the one with straps, because I'm wearing the one with hoses. So let's see. Let's drop one of those. Alright, excuse me. Alright, there's a plethora of people up top, so let's head that direction. Oop, keep going. Keep going. Alright. Let's see. Left arm. I might need that. What am I on? Alright, so we have the Raider leathers. We have the right arm, right leg, and left leg. So we have both the legs and the right arm. Ah, left arm. There we go. Okay. All right, Kate. I got all the toys.
Hey.
Okay. So we're going to give you those, that, and that. So there we go. There's... that, and we get that. Alright, there we go. So that is Sakud with straps, left leg, left arm, right leg, right arm. Oh, she doesn't have a chest piece. Dang it. Alright, hang on. Hang on, we'll find you, let's see if we can, if we're really lucky we can get, let's see. Leather, road leathers. What do you have? Sakud, Leather left leg, grilled leathers. That's just a very long since dead guy. That's pretty funny. I forgot to even be looking for a chest piece of any kind. Well, they have the harness, which isn't great, but it's better than literally nothing. Dun 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 dun. Again, a harness. A lot of them are wearing harnesses, which harnesses are not great. They provide very little protection. Alright, I guess we'll take the harness then. If the options are that or nothing. Let's see if I can find her now. Oh, Kate. Kate. Now, she's pretty intense, can be hard to get along with, so we'll see if she pisses me off too quick or if it works out. There you are. Hey.
Hey. This better be.
Okay. Let's give you that. Oh, is the Raider leathers, like, instead of the harness, or what?
Right,
hang on, that's not... Yeah, I think the Raider leathers were better, weren't they? Yeah. There we go. Oh, dang it, I think I accidentally picked it up. Hang on. First, give you that. Yeah, okay. Well, then you could drop the harness. Oh my gosh, what's I keep up? Hitting the wrong button. Freaking flip. Alright, try that all again. You can have that. That all of those back have that and that. All right, try that again. So this time, let's see. Did I give her all of it? Stack of hoses. There's the harness. There, oh, there we go. Okay, Raider leathers. So let's see. Alright, I guess give me the harness. I guess I'll take it. Alright, you can equip those. Tempted to ditch the hood. Alright, you can have that. Well, you can have it. It's fine. There we go. Alright, now the weapon. I want you to have your bat back. Here, have your bat. Alright, anything else that I accidentally grabbed from her that's actually I want her to have? Doesn't look like it. There we go. There we go. I mean, she looks like a psycho, but to be fair, she is kind of a psycho, so. Alright, so we'll carry her for a while. And we'll see how, you know, how quickly any of it goes. You know, I mean, we'll see how well any of it goes. It's 100% possible that, I mean, it is 100% possible that she will piss me off and will not want to carry her, and that'll be the end of it. But, you know, who knows? I am trying to be... with my character and the RP I'm trying to go for, maybe it'll end up working out fine. We'll just have to see. We'll have to see. If nothing else, it'll shake it up, and odds are she'll be better about staying out of my way than the dog is, because Sam is always under your feet, all the time. Okay, maybe in time we'll find her some better armor as well. We'll have to see. Alright, so let's see here. Oh yeah, that's the... how much junk am I carrying? A fair amount. I mean, enough that we need to drop it off. Plus, we don't have a lot of weight to begin with anymore. Okay. Let's go ahead and go drop off our goodies here. We'll drop off our goodies here. And we'll clean out some of the extra eggs. We picked up a lot of drugs, to be honest. And let's see. Anything else we need to do? Anything else we need to do? And then maybe we'll figure out what we're going to be doing next. Okay, so as far as clearing things out goes, we can put all that in there. There we go. Oops. And then, let's see. I don't think there's anything in the gun department we can set down. I guess we can just put the harness in there. Okay, now aid-wise. So, put one of those back. We can put back the corn because it's like a plantable thing, and I don't usually carry that stuff. Alright, jet, we can't, we have too much of it. Put two of those back. Mentats, put one of those back. Wow, we have a lot of stuff, dude. We can put back like 7 of those. Okay, let's see. 3 of those put back. We'll put back the Nuka-Cola Quantum. It's usually pretty good enough. That's not even worth it. 4 rads is pretty aggressive. We'll put back 3 of those. Put back 4 of those. 4 of those. There we go. Okay. Let's see here. Anything else? Yeah, 2 rads ain't that good. Put all those back. I guess those aren't the worst. There we go. Okay, well, that helped out. Much better. You ready, Psycho? There's just cows everywhere. Or Brahmin, whatever. Brahmin. Okay. Alright, maybe we should hop on something, shall we? Let's see. I kind of want to press forward with the with maybe that. We also could grab that one. That wouldn't be terrible. Let's see. We also could just, you know, start clearing out some locations as well. Twouldn't be the worst thing. Let's see. We could do that one. I mean, that guy doesn't matter that bad, right? I mean, it doesn't matter that bad. All right, maybe we'll go ahead and hit that. We'll get rolling on it. It's pretty funny that, like, the moment I grab Kate, I'm like, all right, let's go talk. And she's like, why are we talking about anything? So, you know, we'll see. We'll see. For now, we'll carry her with us, and maybe it'll be great, maybe it won't be, but, you know. We'll find out rather fast, because I imagine Kate is a pretty outspoken individual. Now, previously, I've never carried her, because, like, obviously, with whatever RP I was doing, it never worked out, carrying her, but, you know. Anyway.
Matt.
Hey, lady. That interview you did with Piper is really selling. Here's your free coffee.
Thank you. Alright, mostly I just didn't want that objective on my screen, to be honest. TBH. TBH.
So thirsty. Doctor says I can't drink liquor no more. Cola. Need a Nuka-Cola.
Sheffield.
Thirsty.
Here, man.
Here you go.
Hey, that was ours.
All right,
you.
Kate didn't
thank
like
you.
That. You're welcome. And shut up, Kate. It was free experience. I have a million of those things. I have more Nuka-Cola than I could ever drink right now. Like, I've started to dump them in my workshop back in my main base because I have so much crap. Unpleasable, you know that?
This mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
All I can see is I'm assuming that's Kate. Oh, there we go. There's me.
Happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into scary pre-war ruins.
Look, I had to, man. I needed him to help find my kid.
I know an amount wasn't on the table when you went out to find him, but you deserve a reward, plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa, one case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
Done.
We're trying to find someone who's gone missing. The devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can.
All right.
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. A lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. What else can you tell me?
My husband was murdered. He was just trying to keep them from taking Sean, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers. They waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. Anything else you remember?
We're looking for my baby, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care. The baby needs a lot of it. That confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. A lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the gunners. And of course there's the Institute.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, where they are. Not even me. I'm a synth myself. Discarded prototype, anyway.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
Right. Speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper. Across your face.
Not much to go on. But a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far in the violence business. What else?
The man who killed my husband, he had a handgun. I didn't get a clear look at it, but that sound...
Could have been a large caliber revolver. Huh. I'm starting to get a clearer picture of the kind of man our perp is. Anything more you can tell me?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was kind of a hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head, scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
I might have. Everything was foggy.
Way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
Maybe it's another kidnapped kid.
Yeah, either that or he's got a son of his own. Not a comforting thought in any case. Both of them vanished a while ago. Haven't been heard or seen since. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
No problem. Let's go after you, Nick. Don't let me get in your way. I mean, it's crowded in here, but, you know. We're like shotgun twins. I thought it was loading out. I'd be like, I can't leave. Don't worry, give it a minute. It's because he's probably standing in front of the door. There we go. All right. On the trail. After you. It's a little dark. Let me light this up for us.
I think you should know. Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance? Bad news. He's more than just a mercenary. He's a professional. Quick, clean, thorough. Has no enemies, but they're all dead. Except you. 9-1
It's a problem.
Team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later. Not many mercs of the Commonwealth can pull that off.
It's true. It's pretty, you know, it's a tall order, to be sure. Now, I wanted to see. There we go. Polish off our health a little bit. Oh, I thought it's all gunfire. It's all flashes of light. I'm like, whoa! There's gunfire happening. Sure, man. I'll keep an eye out. And me and my follower here will look as intimidating as possible.
Why don't you give it a try?
Let me know if you want me to help with that lock.
Look alive.
Yeah?
Go check that out.
I'm out of bobby pins. Have any on you?
See if you can get that door open.
Lock tight. Nick.
Get through that door.
No, it's a master lock, dude.
We need to find the key. See that platform in the distance near the city entrance? That's the elevator to the mayor's office. Why don't you go ask around there?
Whoa! Suddenly, Kate.
I can jimmy this lock.
All right, man. Oh, it's just habit to walk with my gun out, but you know you don't technically need it. I also never play in third person. I've tried a couple times, it didn't go swimmingly, but every once in a while I like going third person just to remind myself what I look like.
Your friend looks like trouble. I'm sure she's not.
That's fair. To be fair, my friend is trouble. To be fair, she's not someone you want to mess with. Alright. Come on, Kate. You coming or what? She's coming. Alright, well, it's a little close. I can't get to the button. Alright, let's go. We look like a bunch of serial killers. Yep, we are definitely murderers. That's for sure. That is for sure. I like this armor and everything, but to be honest, kind of miss my old leather armor serial killer look. Leaning that direction.
Afraid of talking to the press? Bet if I said I was with the Institute, he'd come running.
You ever think maybe you could get a man's attention easier if you use softer words, honey? Maybe shout a little.
She brings up an excellent point, Piper.
Reminds me of this article I'm writing about the mayor's affair with a certain airheaded.
Kate. Mom. Kate, where are you going? All right.
What brings you to the mayor's office, huh?
Need to see the mayor about something.
Really? You came to the mayor's office to see the mayor. Who'd have thought?
Don't get snarky with me, woman. You asked.
Keep your secrets. Sooner or later, I'll find out. I always do.
If you are done crowding the reception area, Miss Piper, the mayor needs to make time for more responsible citizens.
Do I look responsible to you?
I was just leaving anyway.
Bye.
The mayor's receiving visitors as long as they are members of the press. Did you need help?
I need to talk to someone about Kellogg's old house in the West Stands.
Mr. Kellogg's residence? He left town a while ago. We foreclosed on the property and locked it up. If there was something belonging to the man that you have a claim on, you could ask the mayor to hear you out. No guarantees.
I'll talk to the mayor then.
He set aside time to talk to petitioners all day. Best of luck.
Thank you. All right, watch out, watch out. Hey.
Yes, I remember you, our new arrival. I wish I was in your shoe.
Whoop, sorry.
A man named Kellogg used to live in the city. I need to search his house.
I see. Well, whatever reasons you have, I take my citizens' privacy very seriously. even after they've left. I can't allow you to invade someone else's home. That's all there is to it.
Please, Mayor McDonough. This man, Kellogg, kidnapped my baby. I need to find him.
Oh, of course.
Kate disliked that. Screw you.
You overcome this horrible personal tragedy. I remember Mr. Kellogg. Didn't like him much, though. Paranoid. Never talked to anyone. I doubt you'll find him. But I insist you take the key to his old house. It's been abandoned, though. I'm afraid this whole thing might be fruitless.
Okie dokie. Thanks, man. Hey, Kate.
Look alive.
What is it?
I need to ask you something.
What do you want?
Get
it's
lost.
It's about time for you to go, Kate.
I'll head out. But I'm not gonna lie to you and say I'm happy about it. If you change your mind, you know where to find me.
Leave. Literally, like, we've had her for, what, I don't know, what, 10 minutes? And in fact, I'm gonna lock you out. Good luck waiting for the elevator, idiot. Anyway, we've had her, like, what, 10 minutes? And, like, I've talks twice, and she's made, you know, Kate dislikes that. Well, Kate can kiss my butt. Because, like, you can't just go blowing everyone's heads off all the time. Like, you know what I mean? Like, high charisma goes a long way. You can often talk people into helping you when otherwise they wouldn't have been willing to. And, like, you know, and even my character, although, you know, we've talked about this, that, you know, she's very much out for herself, and she's very, you know, and she's out for her family and her, you know, her and Sean is who she's really looking out for. And otherwise, she doesn't trust anyone else, and, you know, and that type of thing. Now, she has a few people that she's, like, you know, sort of making contacts, like Nick Valentine, for instance. You know, that she's making contacts with people that, you know, they're not, maybe not really friends, but they know each other, and maybe they're, you know, they're friendly, maybe, you know, maybe that type of thing. But anyway, it's just like, but, you know, but Kate's strategy is, you know, you just shoot everyone who you don't like, so it's just like, oh, I'm just tired of hearing you talk, Kate, shut up.
Alright, let's head in. You do the honors.
Alright, in we go. And, really quick, Nick, why are you smoking? Like, what around. Lungs are you smoking for? I admit you look super cool when you do it, though. You look super cool when you do it, but man, let me just say, it seems a little funny. I'll be like, well, I mean, he doesn't have to worry about lung cancer. Oh, look, I found a button. Oops. I agree. Boop. I'll be there in a minute. I need to run up here and grab these. Ooh, handcrafts will have a screw in them. That'll have oil in it. All right. Ammo! More ammo! Alright, food. Drinks and food! Yeah, we'll definitely be running back pretty soon to home base. And, yeah, we'll definitely be running back to home base to drop off a lot of this stuff, because we are carrying a lot of weight full of food now. Combat shotgun, heyo. Is that our first combat shotgun? I think so, yeah. Combat shotgun. And we were using the nice, man. Cool. Well, yeah, we will definitely replace that. Ooh, oil can. Also ammo. And some stim packs. It's like a smorgasbord of loot.
Gwinnett stout beer, 44 caliber bullets, cigars, San Francisco sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own.
I wonder if dog meat could pick up the scent.
Say, that's not a bad idea. Some dogs out there in the Commonwealth can track a man for miles. Why don't you go fetch him and let him have a whiff? See if he picks up the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. You have to face Kellogg on your own. Just say so.
I don't know. I might need your help on this one. But maybe I should go on my own.
If you need me, just come knocking. If not, Then, the next time I see you, I hope it's with your son, safe and sound.
Thanks, Nick. I would carry you, but to be fair, most of my decisions are going to be pretty selfish and not very nice, and you're not going to like that, so... Otherwise, it's too bad, because I love Nick Valentine. But alas, with this RP and playstyle and going a little more selfish and, you know, like I said, we'll be friendly with him because he's being obviously super helpful and everything, but, well, that's convenient.
Dog hey. Meat. Get the scent, boy.
We've already talked about this. It's her name is Sam, short for Samantha, and it's probably female, okay? Anyway,
take me to him, boy. Take me to Sean.
It's like that'll work.
Kind of song. Listen, you can hear people's lives and problems as they rush on by.
It's pretty deep, Nick. Sorry, pups, let's go. After you. We do need to dump our inventory, though, but we will do that after we get to our destination, because then we'll be able to teleport there once we see it, so. That's the plan. Luckily, I also know where we're going, but there's like little markers and stuff you have to hit along the way, so we're going to follow Dog Meat's trail. I mean, Sam. We already talked about this. We're gonna follow Sam's trail, but I know where we're going, obviously, but. The real reason we're hitting story stuff a little bit fast is because I'm trying to trigger something specifically, which after we finish this mission that we're on, like following Dog Meat, it gets triggered, which is what we're after. So, in case you're wondering what I'm doing, there is a purpose. Do not worry, there is a purpose. I'm not just crazy. After you, pup. We got kind of unlucky as far as armor for the dog goes. It's kind of interesting that we never found like light armor or heavy armor or anything. Because in my other personal playthrough, I think I'm a little bit higher level, but I found like dog armor pretty stinking fast in my other one. So it's interesting. It is interesting. Do not worry, I know where it is. Over here.
San Francisco Sunlights. Kellogg's preferred brand, all right.
There you go, pup.
Kellogg's still out there.
We've got to track him, boy. Okay, boy. Let's track him.
Lead the way. As we trek across the wilderness, follow the railroad tracks. Full speed! You ready for ambush by mole rats? You ready for it? There you go, see? What did I just say? Anyone else? Alright, we'll take... Oh, I was gonna say, well, let's take the meat, we don't need the teeth, but I guess we'll take it all. Yeah, because you can cook mole rat meat for some good stuff. We'll take the irradiated blood for now, eventually it'll be nice. For now it's not, but later on it will be. The meat's good, nuclear material, the hide is what we really need. We need leather. Always, perpetually, we need leather, so. Okay, I think that's a few of them, but to be fair, we don't need to grab all of them, so. Okay. Lead the way, pup. And the reason that I'm all very familiar with what this is, because I really, really recently did this mission on my other personal playthrough that I'm doing. I did this mission very, very recently, so it's kind of fresh on the brain. It is fresh on the brain, no? Don't worry, I know right where's the clues are. But first, hang on. Take those. Alright, nothing from my character. Take all those.
Bloody bandages. Dog meat can track this.
Hey, pup.
I need your nose to track Kellogg, boy. Okay, boy. Let's track him.
After you. Take all those, thank you. Alright. The Flight of the Valkyries. We're on the trail of Kellogg. All in all, pretty proud of that accuracy. We'll take all the meat, because we can cook it. I'm coming, you're much faster than me, alright? After you. Oh, hang on, I'm having a flashback. Don't worry, we're gonna... Assuming the spawns are the same, we're gonna need this in a second. Ah, there it is. That's what I was waiting for. Haha. We're good. I will take the meat and the hide. Thanks, nerd. Alright. Keep on going, pups. You wanna go? I will knock you out. No, probably not. Huh? Oh. Yep, just regular old settlers. Well, back hurts. Good day to you. I did not ask if you were in pain, bro. But hey, to be fair, life hurts. Alright. We're obviously not doing that right now. No matter what's in there. After you. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Keep on going, pups. The clue is butt lower. What's really funny? As if I don't see that right there. Lols.
A decoy, huh? Clever.
Yes, it is good thinking, no? Alright. Nothing good there. Okay. Sorry, dog. I'm here. Let's go. Sorry, dog. With a G to show that we're tight. Fall through the bridge. He's like, Alex, are you okay? I'm fine, thanks. Man, that's what I call getting spawn killed. He's like, all right, spawn camper. Get back. I bet you, oh, there's radiation somewhere nearby. It hurts. It hurts. Anyway, I bet that little place is full of ghouls or something else pretty sinister. We're not exploring it right now, but you know, we'll see it all in time. It matters not. Been a problem? Oh dear. There, don't be so paranoid. Just a quick little accurate spray. We'll finish him up. It's like, finish him, puppy. Show me you have the drive. After you. Do, 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 do. Ooh. There's some super mutants over there. Exercise extreme caution. Hey! Ugh! Kobe! Can't see him, dog. You're gonna have to come a little bit this way. Oh, look, you warped over here. All right. Oh, let's go get him. Hey, man. Thanks for showing up.
You guys want to see something funny? Let me show you the Super Mutants orders. They always crack me up. You guys ready for this super complex orders? Ready? Kill, loot, return. All right, solid. Thanks for the orders, bro. All right, now we can actually go back to our, you know, legit clue here.
What have we here?
Error. System corrupt. I can't feel my legs.
Yep. Oh, hang on.
This had to be Kellogg.
Why it's so quiet, I don't know. Well, there we go. We got it. Mush, puppy. Come on. I know you know where he is. Don't you? Don't lie to me. You having a problem? Huh? There we go. All right. Just remembered we were on a mission. Good talk. It threw him off with the whole super mutant attack thing. And to be fair, I don't think that one wasn't scripted, like... Those super mutants, I've never been attacked there before by those guys, so that part of it wasn't scripted, which is probably the reason that Dogmeat didn't know what to do, or, you know, Sam didn't know what to do with herself. And yes, I say her, because we already had this discussion. Because A, Dogmeat's a stupid name, and the quote-unquote voice actor for the dog is a female dog, so, you know, therefore girl, there you go. There you have it. The logic. There you go. We're getting close, peeps. We're getting close. Almost there. Radstag. I don't want any trouble with you. Oh, gross. Stupid bug.
What do you think, boy? Huh? Is this our man?
Is it though? He's like, see. See means yes. I knew it. Place that reference. Everyone's like, the 90s Inspector Gadget. I'm like, well done. You are a learned individual. I see you are also a man of culture. It wasn't like an impressive shot or anything. I just like killing things with a sniper. I'm funny that way. Almost there. Whoa, lag spike. All right, we're good. There we go. We did it.
Is this the place, huh? Is he in here, boy?
There we go. Dog is with us once again. All right. Well, we'll go ahead and carry Sam. I mean, obviously, Kate's not going to work out, so she won't work out. All right. Well, let's teleport back to home base. I need to drop. We need to dump our inventory. We need to upgrade our shotgun. We need to upgrade our shotgun. And then I'm gonna probably put Kate on just defense or something, because I don't know what else to do with her. So, and if she's going to be there, she might as well make herself useful. So methinks that's the plan. Okay. Ah, there we go. We already picked up one of the DLCs. So that, the Far From Home, as you can see in the background there, that Far From Home starts the Far Harbor DLC. Now, don't get too excited. We're not there yet, but, you know, we have access to it. Okay. Let's see. I feel like Aid wasn't as bad. Yeah, we can dump the corn. I know that. And this gives us, what, 20 with one rad? That's not the worst thing. Dirty water, we can make a purified water from that, so that's okay. Let's see. Those don't weigh almost anything. We can put the iguana bits back, they're not that good. Okay, irradiated blood we can put back. I know that. We can put back the mole rat meat and the dog and the mutant dog meat. We can put back a nuka cherry. Whoop. Too far. Sorry. Let's see. We can put back both Anuka Quantums, the Orange Man Tats for sure. We can put back the Potato Crisps because they're not that good. We'll put back 5 waters. Put like one rat away. Let's see. We'll carry those. We'll carry that. We'll put back those. That. Okay, that's something now. But first, let's make some. Let's do some cooking. We have some stuff we can make. So first, purified water. That's the first good one. Next, we have the iguana on a stick. Mole rat chunks. We have mutt chops. We have Yao Guai ribs and Yao Guai roast. Let's go Yao Guai ribs. There we go. And then we have vegetable soup. Utility, we don't need that. Okay. Beautiful. There we go. Now we actually made some good food from a whole bunch of garbage. That's nice. Now, let's go ahead and put back Psycho Mark II. And then we will upgrade our new shotgun. Excuse me, puppy, as you bounce off me. Okay, so first, let's go ahead and upgrade as much as we can. So obviously, not automatic, because I don't like automatic pretty much anything. We can go long barrel, because it's just better. We don't have the mods for that. We can do the quick eject mag. Problem is, we're out of adhesive now, so we can get the front sight ring, though. I do like that. We had just enough of that. There we go. That's at least the basic stuff, so that's good. Now, we're going to name this one... Because I like naming my shotguns Psycho after my favorite anime girl. But it's funny because for a while I wanted to call it Psycho, like crazy Psycho, because it made me laugh. But it was getting too confusing and I felt kind of dumb after a while. So then I started naming the combat shotgun Angry Psycho, because it's funny. And I have a really dumb juvenile sense of humor would be another really, really solid reason. Anyway, so we did all we could with the adhesive we had, but I'm pretty happy with where we're at with that. So that's really good. Otherwise, I don't think there's any other weight we can cut too much. I mean, we could probably trim down on weight with this, but we'll hold off for now. We do need to put away all the shotgun mods. Other than that, though, I think we're good to go. Okay. Into Fort Hagen. Let's roll. All right, just wanted to check our time, but we're doing fantastic, which is good. And into Fort Hagen. And yeah, we're pushing a little bit more aggressively on story stuff, because like I said, there is something specific that I am trying to trigger. And after this mission, it triggers. So that is that's why we're doing it so early. Oh, Radstorm. It doesn't matter. We'll be inside in a minute. I'm sure he did. She did, sorry. It doesn't matter. I don't care. There's several turrets up here, so I figured it would be easiest just to take them out now. Turrets are shooting at the puppy. Big surprise. The rads are a little unfortunate, but they're not gonna kill us. Alright, we're gonna run over here. Let's get inside as soon as we can. But I wanted to grab a few of the turrets. There's a couple more down there, but I don't need like six bullets so badly that it's worth doing. It's not worth the rads. Alright, let's hop inside. Let's do this. You guys ready? Are you ready for this? Probably, but here we go. There's a lot of good loot in here. BTW. Oh, hang on. We have to, Whoa! You guys see that? The world vanished and came back. That was fun. Okay, anyway. I have to favorite this. There we go. There it is.
Alright, now first, let's go ahead and dump our extra saves. There we go. Now let's give it a save, just in case anything crashes. Alright, looks like it was maybe a tiny glitch because it didn't come back. As you can see, first of all, turret's about to shoot at me or my dog, I can't tell. Hey. I was like, what the what? Wasn't the most accurate thing I've ever done, but take that. We don't need another power relay coil. Okay. I don't want to get too far ahead before we do our looting, so. Take this. We don't need the Institute pistol. The sights on those things are just dog crap. No offense, pups. He's like, I am right here. I was like, sorry. No offense, puppy. Okay, I think that's where we maybe came in. Screws. Obviously, our biggest thing we're interested in is going to be adhesive, which no surprise there. Stop that. Fusion cell.
Excellent.
Permanently, ballistic weapons permanently do 5% critical damage. Yay! Take those. Odds are we'll be attacked before too much longer again, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who you are. They're like, whatever, the one person is into wrestling, classic wrestling, they're like, yeah! That's such a good reference. Everyone else is like, you're an idiot. Alright, anything super good? Ooh, ammo box. That's super good. It's not less good when I break a bobby pin, but you know, can't have everything.
That's it.
Beautiful, just beautiful. Otherwise, no other ammo. Ooh. All right, that's where we were. Okay. So obviously there's going to be enemies probably down there. Alright, I feel like we're ready to head down the stairs. Let's take out our angry psycho for some close range fights. Hello! Man, that light single-handedly saved that synth from an early death. Okay. We're good. It's on the other side of the wall, in case you're wondering. Let me just come around. Oh, it's chained. Lucky for you. They're like, I don't know how to get to you. But like, don't worry, I'll get around to you. Oh, don't you worry about it. Oh, dude, not far enough. Not far enough. Nailed it.
Yes.
Nothing we need, but other than the free experience. Don't worry, you synth scumbags. I'll be around to you in just a minute. You synth scumbags. And just for clarification, I don't hate them because they're synths. Ow! You think you're funny? Is that what you think? It's Yeah, you like that, nerd? Think you can just shoot at me whenever you want? Hey. Don't worry, pups. We'll get around to them in a minute. We're working our way that direction. Don't you worry, pups. Dog, could you just kindly GTFO? Okay. Nothing good in there or there. There's bullets. That's always good. Ooh, explosives. Give me more grenades. You can never have too many grenades. Nice. There was a booby trap in there. BTW. Good, I need as much 308 as I can get. Because you don't pick it up very fast, so. Screws! And bullets. It's a fork, that ain't bullets. Like, yes, that's very observant of you. Forks are not bullets. Nothing good in there. Alright. Oh, that's not nice. That's what you get for not looking around. Shout out to my character who can just choke down dog food without, like, freaking out. That, I'll take the fuse. The fuse has copper. Copper, sometimes you need it. Na na na. Ooh. Lots of ammo. Ooh, we need the globe. All right. It's funny, I didn't even notice that. Like, yeah, even I'm not that blind. Even I'm not that blind. There you go, just like that. It's all open. Okay, now I don't think I'll be able to open that. I'm assuming it's advanced. Doesn't matter. I mean, it would have been nice to get all that delicious ammo, but you can't have everything. You can't have everything. You can't have everything. You coming in or are you gonna warp down there? All right, see you at the bottom. He's like, I was coming. You'd be like, oh, you were too slow. Maybe you should have been paying attention. Come on, poke your face down the hall. It might be a turret. They might not be able to poke their face down the hall. Right, obviously, we're not going that way. And that's upstairs. Doesn't particularly feel... Oh, I know where we are. This is like super back at the beginning, but obviously we weren't able to go this way at the time. But now we can. The big irony is that I was actually trying to remember to keep lookout for traps. Ooh, we need it. I need it. It's adhesive. The hardest thing to come by and the thing you always need the most of. Adhesive.
Got it.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and take it all. Alright, other than that, anything super juicy? There's some 308 ammo. Be still my beating heart.
You must be.
Shut up. And you must be dead. Alright. Anything, Ah, rude.
Last time we met, you were cozying up to the peas and apple cobbler.
Very funny. Still going with his frozen TV dinner analogy. Huh, I get it, because I was frozen. Dang it, I missed that trap. Wait for it. Wow, my dog's like, yay! Alright. Ooh, pulse grenades. That will be handy. Very, very shortly. Adhesive! Alright, first let's open this. Nailed it.
Yes.
Ammo, and then there's more ammo inside as well. Alright, typewriters are heavy, it has screws, but like, you know, at what cost? If I had hit that directly, it would have died in one shot, but I kind of panic fired, to be honest. Ooh, a fuse. It doesn't weigh almost anything, and it gives you copper, so... Never. Never! Never! I'm coming for you, bro. Think you could just steal my kid? Huh? Shoot and kill my husband? Huh? And I wouldn't blow your stupid face off? Guess what? You'd be wrong. Oh, dang it. We picked up too much junk along the way. Oh, well, that's easy. We can drop that. Boop. Yeah, see, them things are heavy. We don't need the glass either. That badly. Power relay coils. Copper and steel. That one could be dropped if we get too heavy. That one's one copper and two glass. We can drop that. There we go. Alright, from now on, it's, it is a, you know, be very careful what you pick up. Oh, please. I'd shoot up the Commonwealth. Oh, I really thought that was going to be hit. There we go. Alright, I think if there's another enemy down there, I think it's probably a turret. I know I heard a turret, I just don't know if that's the only thing down there. We can't go in there yet, but don't worry. We'll be there soon. I'll take those. And those. Don't need that. Okay, can't go in there. But narrows down where we're supposed to go, don't you think?
whatever you hope to accomplish in here, it's not going to go your way.
Yeah, yeah. Your threats mean nothing to me, boy. I'm coming for revenge. Ooh, 3 fusion cores. That was super good. We don't need those. We don't need the weight, that's for sure. Oh, I wish I could open that. Oh, wait, I can. I was thinking that that terminal was connected to this, but I think it must be connected to maybe the turrets or something else. Possibly.
Sweet.
Ooh, bobby pin box. And money, which weighs nothing, so we can pick up as much as we want. Those are all Raider stuff. Now it's sturdy, but we've kind of moved on. There's some free heal stuff, which is good. Alright, we don't need those. We can't spare the weight. Alright. Come on, pup. Ah, there's another turret right over here. Oh, there's also some synths as well. Pup! If you could just not, like, jump right into the way in the line of fire. Hey, you think I'm scared to come get you? Is that what you think? Shut up. Also, we leveled up. Ooh. Another fusion core. We're gonna need a lot of these, considering we're gonna be wearing power armor eventually. Okay, level up. So, we're level 16. So next level, we can get the ability, so we take no more radiation from eating or drinking. Are you guys excited? I hope you are. You should be. So we could grab this because at level 20 we can grab this, and it will slowly regen health. Which is good. This one is nice because men suffer 10% more damage in combat and they're easier to persuade in dialogue. They're also easier to pacify with intimidation perk, which is way down here at the bottom, which we might grab. That could be good. Let's see. We could grab more damage from rifles, or we could grab the first level of pistols. We could also grab bloody mess because we can't get the more ammo yet. Which would give more damage, about 5% bonus damage, and they'll sometimes explode, which could be good. Let's go ahead and grab the extra health, because then after that we'll be able to grab the, I guess it'll be in 2 more levels, because the next level we're absolutely going to grab, the perk so we take no more radiation from eating or drinking, because it is just invaluable. Okay. We don't... Can't spare the weight for any of that. Nice. Somebody was drinking in the shower. Which, to be fair, who drinks in the shower? Alright, that's all that way. Alright, come on, pup. Come with me. I don't know if there's anything good, but of course we will look, because it is the right thing to do. I saw that. Darn it, you stupid dog. Shotgun shells.
Hey, boy.
I'm going to shoot you. Nice. We got some ammo. That was worth it. Despite the fact that dog meat tried to prevent us from doing so, we still did it. So up his nose with the rubber hose, as my dad says. Fusion cell. I can't spare the weight for extra oil. Hopefully this has adhesive. It probably will. That will be something that's worth prioritizing. See, Wonder Glue. What did I just say? Ooh, also ammo. Okay. Come on, dog. Where is it? There you are. Give me that. Give me your ammo. We don't need those. I only cared if they were going to give us, oh, look. Energy weapon bobblehead. Permanently gain 25% critical damage with energy weapons. Ooh, there's explosives. Problem is, grenades and things take weight, and we don't have a lot of That's weight. Alright, luckily we can swing that, apparently, so that's good. Alright.
Is someone present?
Down, boy. No fear. Do not panic, my friends. Just calm in the face of danger. I laugh in the face of danger. That's right. I'm a cultured soul. That's right. I'm cultured. I can do Warcraft 3 references. I mean, obviously, that reference was a... I'm assuming it's a reference to Lion King. I would assume. I laugh in the face of danger. But I think it was the... what are they? The Goblin Zeppelins? Is that what they're called? But yeah, they're like the Zeppelin... The Zeppelins that will fly you around, that was one of their quotes, was, I laugh in the face of danger! Ha ha ha! And they had like this insane laugh. There was so much fun. So we did pick up...
Oh. It's admirable. You are in over your head in ways you can't possibly comprehend.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so we picked up the armory password. Ah, Stimpak. I said, that's why you look around, kids. Ooh. Right away. Oh, we're too heavy now. That's what happens. Alright, anything we can drop? That's a lot of circuitry, dude. Alright, we need to prioritize. Let's see. I think we dropped the oil. We need oil, but I need adhesive more. Okay. Whoa! Well, there we go. Was a little intense, gonna be honest. Didn't expect them to be standing right there, but we got it. Alright, let's see. No rads for this, so we'll go ahead and drink it. There's no rads from it, plus it weighs a lot. So the sooner we can get rid of that, the better off we'll be.
It's not too late. Stop. Turn around and leave. You have that option. Not a lot of people can say that.
Uh-huh. Can't stop, won't stop. My only option is to by blowing your stupid face off, bro. I'm coming for you. First of all, open this door. There's gonna be ammo in here, and I want it. There's my dog getting in trouble. Yeah, we'll get to you. Ooh, Stimpak. Stimpak. Darn it.
I got too excited.
Little higher. There it is. There it is.
Sweet.
Duct tape. Woo! We don't really need Rad X, to be honest. We have a million of it already. Nailed it.
Yes.
10mm round. Fat man. Fusion cell, mini nuke. Yeah, no, there's guys coming. 10mm rounds. 5.56. Alright, so there is a fat man over here, but I don't think we need it. I mean, I think we already have a fat man. We might already have one. And it will be in our storage if we do. But yeah, we don't have any weight at all. So that's the first problem. So, but yeah, I just don't think we need it. I think we're doing fine without it. I was like, is there a synth in the bathroom? A synth is about to eat shotgun, but no. There was no stinking synth in the bathroom.
Nice.
There is some free stim packs, though. And some free ammunition. Other than that, ooh. Permanently more difficult to detect while sneaking. Never turn that down. We don't have the weight to spare for anything that's not, like, you know, crazy important. Whoa! Alright, maybe a little bit overkill. Wasn't the calmest thing I've ever done. There we go. That one was much more calm. Nothing good there. Ammo. Bobby pin. Yes. Ooh, there's more. More bobby pins. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Lovely. Okay. Anything good behind the desk before I get too aggressive there? Ooh. Alright, watch out, pups. I need that. Oh, I wish I had the weight, but I don't. I very much don't have that kind of weight.
Okay. You made it.
Ooh, military grade duct tape.
My synths are standing down. Let's talk.
I can't wait. Okay, you guys ready for this? So let's see. Grenade wise, what do we have? We have frag grenades, we have Molotovs. I know I have pulse grenades that I picked up. I guess that'll be our best option against the synths, so. Okay, let's go ahead and give this a save in case this confrontation goes horribly. Let me get more adjusted and ready for war. Alright.
You murdered my husband. Took my baby. You're a dead man.
Your husband. It was a regrettable accident. Still, this world, this life, you've seen it. Pain, suffering. Death is its only escape. Don't worry. Sean's fine. Maybe a little older than you expected, huh? I can't give him to you, because he ain't here.
Fuck you, Kellogg.
Let him go. Your time's done. Your son is exactly where he belongs. He's home. In the Institute.
The Institute? Well, I'll find him no matter where he is. Nothing will stop me.
God, you're persistent. I give you credit. The way a parent should act. The way I'd be acting if I were in your place, I like to think. Even if it is useless. But I think we've been talking long enough. We both know how this has to end. So, you ready?
I'm gonna make you suffer.
Oops. Sorry. Oh. Excuse me. Alright. Now let's go ahead and get this. And. Let's see here. We don't need that. We need. Let's see. Do I have anything that's not gonna, like. There we go. That'll work. Alright. Let's see. Whoa! Sorry, that was a panic shot, but got him with the other one. You still there? Oh, you are. How predictable. Woo! I know, it hurt. It hurt bad. It hurt bad. Yeah, that was a great grenade, and I didn't react in time. So, to be fair, I kind of deserved that. Alright, I kind of deserved that. Where are you? You still hiding there? Nope. Ah, I hit him. Ah, gotcha, nerd. He was about to say, I feel sorry for you, you came all this way for nothing. I imagine. He was wrong. Okay, let's go ahead and do our rightful looting as we deserve. Right, there's one. I know there was 3 cents total, so we'll get to you in a minute, alright? Alright, bro. That was for my baby. You filthy kidnapper. Ooh, stem pack. And a blood pack. Gimme. You don't need folders. I do need, ooh, a dick doll. Yes. Bobby pin box. Of course, always good. Both of those are great. I'll take this. You don't need those. Ah, there's a chest. Leaded raider left. That's interesting. Take that. Has some free caps. Alright, so there's the one dude we killed. I know that there was other synths. There was 3 of them. And to be fair, there was some grenades thrown and, you know, they could be scattered all over creation by now. To be fair, and it's only going to be, they're only going to have a couple of rounds. There we go. There's one of them. There's one of them. I imagine one of them is like, whatever, blown from the side of a building or something somewhere. Blown through the wall of the map. Because that was the guy that, I think one of the guys that I shot this way, because I think the first dude where I turned around just domed him as I was taking cover, I think he's just gone, which doesn't matter. Like I said, he's only going to have a few rounds anyway, so it's not even worth that much. Okay, give me the terminal password. Give me that. Give me his sweet pistol. That's his sweet pistol. Want that. Give me the grenades, the stealth boy, both of those, and give me your outfit. Don't worry, it'll be worth it. Don't worry, it'll be worth it. Everyone's like, you have a problem. Wait for it. Don't worry, everybody. It will be worth it. Alright, gonna be honest, it's definitely not gonna be worth it. I mean, we're still gonna do it, but it's not gonna be worth it. Oops. Alright, good. We deactivated it. There we go. That was for my kid, idiot. Alright. Yeah, everyone's like, yeah, that definitely wasn't worth it. So, what we're wearing is definitely way better than this outfit. I mean, we're still gonna wear this outfit, but it's way worse for sure. So, let's go ahead and drop all of this. Because that'll make our weight almost to the point where we're okay. Health-wise, we could eat something, help get rid of the weight problem. Okay, what else we could do? We can drop all 6 of those. There we go. That we dropped a pound there. We need the recorder. There we go. Okay, that got us really close. Let's drop the other circuitry. Nope. Not enough. All right, we're going to drop one more board. There we go. We did it. And we still managed to wear Kellogg's outfit, which is what I wanted, TBH. Yes. All right, actually, that's the other thing I wanted to drop. We can drop that sack hood with hoses. There we go. Look how styling we are now, man. We're definitely going to add more to it. Like, we'll find some sunglasses or something. But, hey, that's awesome. Okay. Security door protocol. Open sesame. Alright, discuss your findings with Nick. Let's do it. Man, we look so stinking sick. It's actually unbelievable. We look so cool. Hey, and it's nice to get a change of scenery, man. I realize that, you know, quote-unquote, it's not the most, you know, competitive option, but... You know, I've been trying to do that in this game. It's trying to be a, ooh, duct tape. It's trying to be a, I'm trying to make it a priority. I started doing it in one of my other playthroughs, for a personal one that I was doing to side with the Minutemen, because I wanted their achievements for their ending. There's some certain outfits that I wanted to wear, but they were way worse than what I was wearing. But what I decided is, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna wear whatever I want, and we'll just get perks to make it okay. This outfit is a great example of that, because it's not quote-unquote the most competitive option. It's not the most competitive option because it's way worse than what I was wearing, But it's like, it's so much more, it's so much cooler than what I was wearing. Like, I look so much more cool. So it's one of those situations where you're sacrificing what's better for what you want. And so, you know, with that in mind, we're going to be getting perks so that we're much more tanky. And so we can maybe help, it'll help us get away with, it will help us get away with, oh, there we go. That's about to sound like so confused. Anyway, it'll help us get away with wearing what we want. And that's really important to me. There we go. That is what I was trying to trigger.
People of the Commonwealth, do not interfere. Our intentions are peaceful.
That's why we brought an army.
We are the Brotherhood of Steel.
Wow. Look at that. Look at that ship. And all of the vertibirds, I think is what they're, I think is what those were called. Started Shadow of Steel. Alright, that wasn't that AF-95.
Repeating. This is Paladin Dance on frequency 95. All Brotherhood of Steel units are to return to the Cambridge Police Station immediately for reassignment. Repeating.
Alright. Oh, we might as well listen to the other one.
This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat. This is Ellie.
So, this radio station.
Okay.
We don't really make any...
That's what I wanted to trigger. I wanted to get that going because the Brotherhood doesn't show up like in force until you do that story mission. So I wanted to hit the story mission so that we could trigger them, so that they would show up. So anyway, that was one of the biggest reasons that we did that. So very happy with that. Now, yeah, so now the Brotherhood is here, and so we can really get kicking off our Brotherhood. Now, this point specifically is super important and big for our RP, because before, she was already sided with them after seeing Paladin Dance and stuff, and she's like, look, the Brotherhood's a powerful military force, I want to side with them so that mostly, I mean, it's, you know, it's completely selfish, but I want to help them, I want them to help keep me alive, you know, and that's how, just that's just how she is. But that point was big where she's like, you know, like, these guys are, like, unstoppable, like, you know, she's like, you know, like, look at that, like, you know, and so that's... Makes her feel even more justified in siding with the Brotherhood. So, anyway, so that was like a big point in our RP, and so that's super cool. I don't know. I don't think there's anything else we can do to Psycho, because we don't have even we have adhesive now, but we just don't have anything we can do with this. And we can improve this armor. I don't think we're gonna carry this pistol, and we're gonna put back Rick. We're going to put that one back because we're going to trade it for Kellogg's pistol because it refills your action points on a critical hit. So it's a little bit better, but it also just has all the best mods on it. So it just hits harder anyway. So we're going to go ahead and drop, I think it was Rick. Yes, we can put back Rick and Kellogg's pistol. As you can, I mean, it doesn't do more damage right there, but it's okay. Don't worry, it'll be great. There we go. Okay, so now we can go ahead... And Kellogg's pistol, so we can go ahead and favorite that. I'm gonna put it right there, just where the other one was, but now we just have a better version, so that's an improvement. All right, now let's go ahead and check up on our aid. Let's see if there's anything we can think about downsizing a little bit. We can go ahead and drop all the dirty water, the gourd as well. Let's see. Can drop that. I have plenty of really good food, and pretty soon we'll be able to eat whatever without getting without taking rads in the next level, and so very soon all of eating will be so much easier, and a lot of things will just be so much easier. So before long, will be in good shape. We can drop like 5 of these. Like, you get purified water so fast. We have way too many of those. We have 6 of those. 5 of those. Could drop that. I got plenty of good food. That too. We'll drop the one with rads. Keep that. There we go. Very, like I said, very soon we'll have better stuff. All right. Now, there wasn't too much we can cook with. One of the things we could, though, is we can make another purified water from the dirty water. So, and again, before too much longer, none of that will matter. We won't need to spend so much time cooking as we do now. And again, you can't actually improve. You can improve the Pit Boy as well, even though it shows up. I've never seen an upgrade for it. Regardless, you can't improve Kellogg's outfit, which is a shame, which is part of the reason why it's not that good, because it's giving you 30 and 30. It's giving you, 30 and 30, but it's also, you also can't improve it. So, it's kind of weird like that. But anyway, let's go ahead and go to Nick's detective agency. Let's talk to him. Let's show him what we found, which will be super sweet. And, yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Oh, I meant to assign What's-Her-Face to defense. Okay, so we're pretty close to out of time, and there's not too much else we're going to do. There is a few things. So one of the things we're going to do, of course, first we're going to talk to Nick. We're going to finish up that mission. Then while we're in the city, we're going to go and look into getting a tattoo or some markings or something, because I feel like at this point she's feeling pretty tough, and she kind of wants to get some... I did, actually. Anyway, but yeah, we're going to look into getting a tattoo or some markings, because at this point, she's getting more and more hardened, she's getting more and more used to things, more and more used to things, and with the Brotherhood showing up, she feels like she's more deserving these days.
She's my client, Piper. Why don't you learn not to snoop on a woman?
There's Nick defending my privacy, as Piper was trying to get... You're in back. Details on me.
Not with your son. What happened?
You were right, Nick.
I look so cool.
Baby. That wasn't all. He was working with the Institute. He gave them Sean.
The Institute?
Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, friend. Truly. That makes things considerably more complicated.
He ain't kidding. Heck, he makes a synth, and even he doesn't know how to get in.
No synth does. Security protocols strip those memories out.
I need to find a way.
I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there, but... To this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg.
He is just very dead.
Whatever you're thinking, it doesn't matter. He's dead.
I'm wearing his clothes.
Figures the Institute's only man on the outside wouldn't be the type to be taken alive.
So, murderer and the kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
He wasn't gonna talk. Even if I had a way of bringing
Which
him.
I wouldn't have done, by the way.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
I hope you're right, Nick.
Let's see. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg
has. It's so weird to see my face, I'm not used to that.
Thing attached to his head.
In any playthrough.
Huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all be running across the Commonwealth. So, who's coming with them?
I have to go to the memory den either way. I'm going to introduce you to Omari. If you want to head there together, just say so.
I'll head there on my own.
All right. See you at the den. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
You're such a good guy, Nick.
Out, I'm gonna do some more research. I'll be at the public.
You're such a good guy, Nick. So much. Much wow. I was gonna grab something. What was I gonna grab? Ah. So that is a detective case. There's a dude missing. Alright, so yeah, there's a dude missing, there's a guy who wants to talk to us, blah 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 blah. Now, there's another one, which is like Marty, isn't it like Marty's holotape or something? Is what it's called? Yes. Sort of, no, Marty Bullfinch's holotape.
Dickie, you old bucket of bolts, it's Marty.
It's Marty!
I know it's been a while, but I came across a little mystery I thought might get your circuits firing. You remember that ugly grasshopper statue on top of Faneuil Hall? Turns out it's got a note in it. A note. By the son of one, Shem Drown. I don't expect that name means anything to you, but the guy was a coppersmith. Way back when folks did shit like that. Apparently, this note leads straight to the old guy's stash. I don't know what's in it, but I'd sure like to know if it's still there. I'm gonna go do a little recon.
Includes the holotape game.
If you decide you want to get the team back together, you let me know.
Alright. Cool, we picked up a mission. There's a dude that wants to talk to us about a missing guy. So, lots of good toys. But, we are on a tiny baby schedule. Now, we're not going to be doing our main story mission for a while. That one will be sitting in blank because that's what I was trying to do. I was just I was trying to trigger the Brotherhood to show up. Like, in, you know, show up in force. And so, mission accomplished there. So, anyway. Okay, so first, let's give it a save, because we're going to go look at the tattoos, but the problem is you can't, like, oops, sorry, I didn't realize, no one get mad at me, alright, anyway, because the only way to look,
no, not now,
I'm like, go away, I'm just trying to wait here, anyway, but, yeah, the only way to look at the tattoos and stuff is if you pay, and obviously, I don't want to waste 100 caps. I don't want to waste 100 caps just because. So, anyway, that's why. That's why. Alright, are you open now? Seriously, why are you not open? Hmm? Why? Alright, hang on. Let's wait another couple hours. Anyway, but, yeah. And so I don't want to waste 100 caps for nothing. So we will use this opportunity to look if they are not, if we don't see anything we like, or if we don't decide to, if we decide to not get one, if there's nothing good yet, then we will, you know, save our money. But, sir, maybe we can talk to this guy first.
New file to open. Do you have a legitimate medical concern? Is this about a facial reconstructive service?
So what kind of treatments are common around here?
Bandaging wounds and cleaning radiation exposure are the most common things you outsiders usually ask for. That and kicking a chem habit.
Not right now.
Very well.
Let me in. Darn it all. Alright, well, maybe we'll leave and we'll come back. I want this to be a thing. I want to look, man. And no amount of them just deciding that suddenly it's not going to work is going to stop me. I want to get some tattoos. I've never gotten tattoos in this game. I've looked at them several times, but nothing ever fit. But this time, something might fit. Because we're actually trying to look fearsome and dangerous and deadly, and our character's hardcore. So, you know, if anyone needed a tattoo, it's definitely her. So let's go here. We'll, I don't even think there's anything to drop, but I just wanted to assign what's her face if we can find her. Alright, so yeah, we don't have the defense or beds, blah blah blah. Her and her needs. Alright, we'll get like a super simple. Okay, first we'll get stuck on the wall. There. We'll just do this. We'll spin it this way. There. Now she has a bed. She has enough food. She doesn't have any water. Hang on. Water. Wait for it. Two. Alright, now she has water. Let's see. Yeah, he's just like frozen in time here. I wonder if I could put him on food. Do it. Well, his thing hasn't changed, but it does kind of look like he's on food. It looks like he's doing it, so that's good. But I need to find wherever the heck she is. Hey! Alright, well, let's go ahead and, hang on. Thank God I was accidentally still in the hole. There you are! Found her! Alright, hang on. First, command. Move it. Alright, now that we found Kate, we can move her over here. Okay, defense, guard posts. Let's just set up something super simple. He's, like, broken. I can't do anything with Codsworth. There, you're on defense. He's still on a caravan that he can't do anything about, so that's a thing. There we go. And here he will wait forever. All right, whatever. Whatever, nerd. I got her on defense, all right? She has a bed now. Like, what else could she want out of life? All right, let's try this again. See if we can go look at tattoos now. I want to look at tattoos, man. I want to get a tattoo or a marking. Now there is lots of other tattoo options in the game. You find lots of unique ones in magazines. And I think at the moment all we have is maybe an anchor or something. So we could. We'll keep our eyes out for any other magazines that can teach us some cool tattoos. But for now, we could at least look at the markings, if nothing else. Come on, 200, come on. Why? Why? I will break and enter. I'll do it. Okay, we are back. So I did some Googling about why I couldn't look into this. It's because we picked up, let me go ahead and show you. Let's see here. This one right here, The Disappearing Act. So we picked this up and it's related to the doctors and there's missing people and whatnot. It's related. So that's the reason I can't get in. So until we do that, it's going to be locked. But obviously we're not doing that this episode, so we will have to get a tattoo another time. Now, otherwise, I think this will be a great place to stop. Now let's go ahead and head on back to Sanctuary and that can be where we call this one. So, but hey, great progress was made today. That is for sure. We got a lot done. We got the Brotherhood to show up. We got a brand new outfit that looks amazing. And when we come back, I think odds are we'll be hitting some missions. Because next level, we can grab the eating and drinking. So we can eat and drink anything without any radiation. So that will be invaluable. Also, we can hit some other missions because we need to start focusing on making ourselves tanky and doing better damage, because the sooner we can do that, the easier everything will be, because we are not very tanky anymore. We tend to be kind of a squish ball, so we have to watch out. So that will be maybe priority next time. We'll be making ourselves kind of as tanky as possible, because we need it. So yeah, that's what I'm thinking the plan is, which is pretty sweet. And otherwise, I think that'll be a great place to call it. We look so stinking cool. Something else on my list, we need to find some sunglasses or a hat. We don't need a hat. The hat is not necessary, but I do want some sunglasses. I've seen some cool ones in the game, so we'll keep our eyes peeled for some good shades. But regardless, that'll be a great place to call it. made really good progress, so that's really cool. And one thing that'll help keep us alive is eventually we're going to be wearing power armor. I fully expect at some point we'll be wearing power armor. And when that point comes, obviously the power armor is going to be our real armor. And so we're not going to need to worry about a lot of things. And so, we're not going to need to worry about being as strong because our power armor is going to be protecting us. So it's not as daunting or as dangerous as it might seem. But regardless, that is fantastic. We made it so much progress. So anyway, that is going to call for this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today, and we will talk to you guys later.